गोवर्धन एंड श्री रिटायर्ड कर्नल आर के सिन्हा. सो लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, प्लीज गिव देम अ राउंड ऑफ अप्लॉज वंस अगेन. एंड नाउ आई रिक्वेस्ट आवर स्टाफ मेंबर टू प्लीज फेलिसिटेट रिटायर्ड कर्नल राहुल गोवर्धन.
Thank you, brother.
And now, once again, I request our staff member to felicitate retired Colonel Ranjit Sinha. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, a brief description about Colonel Rahul Govardhan. Colonel Rahul Govardhan has 30 years of distinguished service in Army, and he has held many important positions, including the commanding officer of the artillery unit in Jammu and Kashmir, Rajasthan, and deputy president of the Services Selection Board. He is a qualified HR professional with post graduation in weapon technology and management, a certified assessor and interviewer who interviewed more than 2,000 candidates for the appointment as defense officer. He took premature retirement to join as the first executive director HR of Maharashtra State Electricity Distribution Company, MSEDCL. After retirement from MSEDCL, he worked for 2 years as director HR for a French collaboration company. Presently, he is working as HR consultant. He has associated with top HR consultants like KPMG, IBPS, and handling assignments of many PSUs like Indian Oil and Bharat Electronics Limited, India HAL, and other private sector companies. He has been actively participating in seminars and discussions as a chairperson, speaker, and at the national as well as the international level. Some of them were organized by World Human Resource Development Congress, USAID, IUKAN, IBPS, Bengal Chamber of Commerce, and People Matters magazines. His contribution to HR profession has been very well organized and was awarded with HR Leadership Award by the Asia Pacific Congress, Leadership and Inspiration Award by Bengal Chamber of Commerce, and Pride of HR Profession at Human Capital Summit Pune. His name was also included in the list of most powerful HR professionals in India at Asia Pacific Congress 2012. He has been a founder editor of Journal on Selection Process and has been writing regularly to HRM Personality Development Infrastructure and selection process in Army journals, magazines, and newspapers. Now I welcome Colonel Rahul Govardhan to go ahead with this presentation. Sir.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Yeah, good evening, all of you. How are you? But I don't see that energy. I was just describing to Kansena that Mumbai people got a lot of energy and all the time they are energetic. But when I said good evening, the energy was low. What is the reason? Because of the time?
Good evening once again, sir. Good evening, sir.
Good evening. Yeah, that's better. Okay, fine. One of the reasons that I decided to come here and address all of you is about self. Okay. When I say self, I must tell you first that I am a Maharashtrian or from a Maharashtra, and therefore I feel that yes, there is a need to address Maharashtrian boys and girls. Why? Because many years ago, when I was like you, I had done my graduation and with some efforts, I cleared my CDS before my BSc examination. And thereafter, I got selected through SSB and everything. And one was very happy. I happened to come to Mumbai because I belong to Nagpur. So I happened to come here. And one of my relative whom I describe how difficult it is to get into the armed forces and that kind of thing. So he was also quite thrilled, Dr. Saab. So he said, okay, we have one relative. We'll go to them in the evening. I said, okay, fine, we'll go. So first thing, when the doctor told him, okay, like Rahul has been selected for Indian Military Academy, and he's joining army soon and this kind of thing. He looked at me, did you get less marks in BSc? I said, my BSc result is yet to come. Then why are you joining army? So, as if I'm committing a suicide, you know. So, his, all the time he was worried that, you know, why should he join army? Okay. So, therefore, after returning to this place, that is, I came after 30 years to Mumbai, 5 years I stayed in Mumbai, then went back to my roots. So, I have found no change. Today, after 42 years also, I find no change. In mentality of all of us is that army is a army or a defense is one of the last options. First thing is that we want to become engineer, and thereafter everything. Okay, so that is the reason I said I will first tell you that why should you join armed forces. Okay, fine. That preamble. Okay, when you decide that, especially. I find any aspirant, I find none, most of them, yeah, you are the one, okay, fine. But most of the people who are now graduate or postgraduate or doing graduation. So therefore, when you think about career, what all you look for? First, you look for pay and perks. So any company which gives a good pay, you consider that company is a good company. Next is facilities. Because when we talk about pay and perks, especially in the private world, when we talk about pay, it means CTC. CTC means if I have a cup of tea, that will also be considered as my part of pay. Okay, everything is transportation, house, everything is considered as all facilities are considered as a part of pay. So therefore, facilities are also necessary in addition to your pay and perks. Next is opportunity to progress. It's okay that initially you are looking for a job, but would you like to serve in an organization where there is no scope to go up or to get a better salary? Certainly not, because you are the one who are looking for a future. It is not you are looking only for today. Okay. Next, transparency in selection and promotion. Would you like to go for an interview where you come to know that they have already decided whom we will select? You just come, go there, and then they'll say, okay, you will hear from us. Certainly not. Certainly not. If you are prepared for some interview, and if you go prepared, first thing you expect, there should be a transparency, and there should be absolutely unbiased attitude. And subsequently, promotions also. Because ye so-and-so ka bhatija hai, ya so-and-so ka wo hai, isliye uska promotion hota hai, nobody will like it. So therefore, in the armed forces, there is nothing known as a partiality. Even if you wish to, you cannot. At Services Selection Board, it's a foolproof system carrying on for many years, and there is absolutely transparency, there is an unbiased attitude, and everybody gets the equal treatment over there. And same goes for the promotions also. Status. I don't think people may be talking about IAS status and IPS status and other things, with due respect to that, because my whole family in the administrative cadre. I am the only odd man out. But then let me tell you, the kind of respect you get in the armed forces and thereafter, I don't think any organization can get. Okay, or anybody can get it. Okay, so therefore, definitely the best kind of status you achieve and you are respected. Next is respect. I'll cover in detail, but yes, everybody wants. To gain a respect. He doesn't want to be one of them. That today what is happening? When you join software company, you are very happy. How many of you are engineers? Few. Okay. So first thing, you know, like campus interview, placement in Capgemini or placement in TCS, Infosys, you are very happy. But do you know that how many engineers they recruit every year? TCS recruits around 10,000. So you are part of that 10,000 base. Now, slowly that pyramid become tougher. One, and at the same time, what you are looking for respect, you are one of them. Out of 10,000, you are also one of them. So therefore, there is no boss. you are also team member. Okay, so therefore definitely when you serve, you would like to have respect, and respect should not be only for money. That yes, at the time of retirement you earn so much of money, you got a good house, so people will respect you. No, people don't respect. Today there is no dearth of money outside. Okay, so therefore respect also. And lastly, post-retirement benefits. After retirement, like today in Mumbai, everybody thinks I must have a good house. You start your career here in Mumbai, first look for ki one BHK mil jayega to theek hai. Phir one BHK after 5-6 years of good service, 2 BHK. You upgrade, and by the time you retire, you have a 3 BHK house. Okay, and then you realize that half of your benefits have gone in your house only. Now you are left with half the benefit, because you will not get pension if you are working in a private company. Okay, so therefore that you realize ki puri zindagi maine Mumbai mein guzari for what? For constructing a house. Okay, so therefore that also benefits also matters. You have to think today. Okay, next. Today's job scenario, which you must be aware also, but I want to highlight that that is the reason government sector job. First of all, in government sector, there are very few jobs available. Why? Because slowly they are tightening the screw, reducing the overheads, and because of the automation, the jobs are shrinking. Okay, so therefore there are very few. And then when the jobs are there, then there is a reservation. In reservation, some of you may qualify for some, but in that particular category, merit will be very high. So therefore, problems are there. It is not open merit. Public sector, the story is same. Except for big public sector. I work for public sector these days on assignments, and I realize that now public sector is also slowly marching towards privatization. Mark my word. Okay, what does this mean? It means that slowly they are also privatizing. Their functions, they are privatizing. So when their functions are being privatized, staff is being reduced. Okay, so therefore the vacancy is also again reducing there. So otherwise, public sector job is a secured job. Government job is secured job. But then if you are looking for a prestige, possibly both the jobs you may not have. Okay, you may have also. Private sector, lot of growth, but what about pay? Today, private sector, next slide I'm going to show you the state of engineers, then you'll realize that private sector jobs are there, but at the same time, number of people who are applying for that because of the upper two jobs, there are very limited vacancy, so lot of people are applying for that. So therefore, private sector is another thing. Foreign jobs, with a change in policy, America, Australia, France, now they have tightened the screw. As a result, what is happening? Very few chances, even after doing MS outside, very few chances that you will get a job on a permanent nature. A temporary job, you may get. Okay, so therefore, we have to think when we talk about job scenario. Yeah, next. Yeah. Now, in 2014-15, in India, there were 3,345 engineering colleges, and 1.5 lakh students graduated. Okay, and they have increased thereafter. It is not that they remained there, but since the data was this thing, then according to the Aspiring Mind, this Aspiring Mind data is not a. This was the data of AICTE. Okay, they had carried out this employment report, which is based on the study of more than 150,000 engineering students who graduated in 2015. 80% did not get placed in campus interview. Okay, 20 to 33% out of the 1.5 million engineering graduates passing out every year run the risk of not getting job at all. And that's a reality. Those who are engineers, they must be knowing it. Okay, yes, you will get some job, but is it engineer job? So therefore, I will call it a false employment. I am employed, but am I my qualification engineer? I am getting an engineer job. Answer, no. Okay. Economic Times says, for those who got the job, the entry level salary is pathetically low. realization that I worked in private sector, believe me, I employed NIT engineers who were not campus placed. They had applied for a job and they started with 20,000 rupees per month salary. Okay, NIT, you have to have something in you. Then only you can, because that is the second level. After your IITs, the second level is NIT. So they are ready to work for 20,000 rupees. And scenario has not changed much. Okay. Similarly, recently, IIM Nagpur, the first batch passed out. Only 50% have been campus based. Mark my word, these are the figures from authenticated source. Okay, 50% have been, sorry. Average salary they got between 9 to 12 lakh rupees. How much? 9 lakh to 12 lakh. That is a 75,000 to 1 lakh. I'm going to show subsequently what army gives you. Okay, or armed forces. Whenever I'm saying army, take it as an armed forces. Okay, I being an army man, that habit. Okay, fine. So therefore, that is the state of affair about the those who are graduates. Similarly, other graduates and PGs, the situation is same. I have given IIM example. There are many of them, but because of the time, I'll not be able to give. Therefore, need to improve employability by having other options. Employability of whom? Ours. Okay. So therefore, we have to think of other options. Yeah, next. What Armed Forces Career offers you? Every year, there are about 2,000 vacancies. All three services, there are 2,000 vacancies. Transparent, unbiased, without any quota, and selection based on merit. If you work hard, you will. If you don't work hard, you will not. Okay. Nobody can influence. Okay. Entry after 12th, NDA. Then there is a technical entry scheme. Okay, you can join that. Then graduation and post-graduation. You know, so you have ample chances. Then personality-based selection system for all. That is after clearing your screening test of this NDA, CDS, APCAT, SSB is a purely, we do not take into consideration what kind of percentage of mark you got, what kind of background you have, who is your father, all those data is there. But then we do not take cognizance of that. What you are is more important. Okay, so can you not improve yourself? Yes, you can. Okay, next is entry to the best training academies. I visited Lal Bahadur Shastri Academy, Mussoorie. I stayed there, and I also visited Sardar Patel Academy at Hyderabad. And since I am a Indian Military Academy cadet, gentleman cadet, so therefore I knew. And then in the army, I visited all our academies. So therefore, there is no comparison of these academies, the kind of treatment you get, the kind of training facilities you have, the kind of sports facilities you have, there is no match. Okay, and next. An opportunity to serve in elite force, all of you know that. Okay. Yeah. Elite force. First of all, we will know what is the strength of the army. I mean, in just nutshell, it's the world's third largest army. 13 lakhs well-motivated soldiers, well-equipped and led by exemplary officers. You must have seen that our ratio, even those people who are getting martyred, our officers die because we lead from front. The very few army in the world, they have traditions like Indian army, okay, that we lead from front. We do not lead from back. Okay. But definitely, yes, I would like to warn you, subsequently I will be covering that, we don't join to get killed. Okay. Our job is not to get killed. Our job is to kill enemy. Okay. Yeah. Well-equipped and led by exemplary officers, ready to take on any kind of emergency. The Indian Air Force, world's fourth largest air force, with about 130,000 flying and supporting staff, about 2,000 aircrafts, equipped with missiles too. Okay. Then Indian Navy, fifth largest in the world, about 60,000 troops, about 200 ships and 200 aircrafts plus missiles. Would you not like to join an organization like this, or would you like to join startup? Okay, if you are starting your startup, I'll appreciate, definitely. Okay, yeah. Prestigious training academy. Okay, quickly we'll go through this. World's one of the best defense training academies, NDA, Indian Military Academy, Air Force Academy, Hyderabad, Naval Academy, and Officers Training Academy, Chennai and Gaya. Then best of the facilities like education, training, lodging, boarding, sports are absolutely free of cost. You don't have to pay during your... The training at the academy is designed to inculcate moral values, leadership qualities, sense of honor and duty, then mental and physical prowess, a spirit of adventure and the will to win. This is achieved by training in the character building, discipline, military and academic subjects and physical exercises, drill, sports and adventure activities. And believe me, you will enjoy doing that there. Degree from a good university for after NDA training. You will get from JNU. You will get a National University degree once you complete your NDA course. Paid in the last leg of training at IMA, Air Force Academy, Navy and Officers Training Academy. If you are joining any of them, you will get pay also. Okay. Yeah. This kind of, if you see the halls over there, dining hall, you can see the main hall, then the sports facility. Can you see this, all this kind in civil? Nowhere you can see this kind of thing. Okay. Yeah. Great job job with security. First is great job of government job of class 1 officer with special status. Okay. No doubt in that. How many of us can become class 1 officer in India? Very few. Okay. Then opportunity to don uniform and serve in elite force. Wearing a uniform comes to you if you join up. Otherwise people, you know, try to wear it in the movies and become a hero. Okay. So in reality, you will get the opportunity to wear uniform and you will be proud of wearing that. Security to self and family, that is a zindagi ke saath bhi aur zindagi ke baad bhi. I have stolen this from LIC tagline. Okay. But yes, what you are considering that zindagi ke saath bhi, zindagi ke baad bhi, no. Not after death, I am talking about. I am talking about during service and after service. Okay, so zindagi means, I am talking about army career, and zindagi ke baad bhi means after army career. Okay, so that security throughout you will get. Attractive pay and facilities, we will cover that. Stay in good environment of cantonment. Camaraderie and leadership, nowhere you can see that kind of camaraderie. That even if suppose my friend comes to know that I am visiting Ludhiana and one of my coursemates is there, he immediately will inform everyone. Same. Like, I met him after many years. Okay. 10 years, sir? Maybe?
And you met here just now.
Okay, 10 years. And then we were talking for 2 hours. Okay. So, that kind of camaraderie is there. Okay. Then, access to the best of the facilities. Okay. Yeah. Next. Okay. We'll cover quickly. Suffice to tell you that with the 7th pay commission coming in, minimum pay you will get, starting pay, 75,000 plus. Okay. Plus, you will get special perks, which will be, as I said, in army we don't count that as a part of pay. That is, it is not a CTC. Okay, so therefore that you will get much more. I don't think any private company today offers a fresh graduate this kind of salary. Okay, and even in even if you become a civil service officer, possibly this is not a starting salary. Okay, yeah, next. Because there is a, that military service pay. This is the pay only in defense you will get. So this becomes an additional advantage. They also start as a class 1 officer, we also start. But then you get a military service pay. Okay, yeah, next. Special perks. Group insurance, then membership of officer mess and club, golf club, gym and library, accommodation in cantonment, about 40 to 50% concession in air and train journey, concession rates on car, bikes, all household goods. And liquor too. I don't wish that you should think about liquor at this stage. Okay, medical facilities to self and family even after retirement. No toll on road. You just have to take out your I card and show it. Mumbai Pune Express Highway, Super Express Highway. You don't have to pay for that. You know. Overall, there are more than 50 facilities. Okay. Yep. Next. Facility like. Free ration, schooling to children, reservation in certain states in education to wards, that is including in Maharashtra, to the wards of serving army officer in best of the engineering colleges and this thing, there is a reservation. In CET also there is a quota, you know, so that kind of facility is available to the wards of the armed forces officer. Pre-medical facilities to dependents, officer mess, canteen facility, gypsy car to senior officers, excellent accommodation wherever you are posted, then air tickets to you and your family anywhere in India once a year, facilities like swimming pool, golf course, tennis court, billiards, squash court and whatnot. Then membership to all these clubs is almost free. They charge you nominal charge, but it's absolutely nominal. Yep. Next. Yeah. This you may not be knowing. We have a lot of opportunities these days to go abroad also. We have awesome foreign assignments and opportunity for higher education. The armed forces selected officers are sent without diplomatic visa to foreign countries as a defense attaché. Very few selected people go. Then large number of they go to young officers, they go to UN peacekeeping mission for 1 year. Okay, you make a lot of money there, in the sense not otherwise, because you are paid in dollars. Okay, and plus your pay here is secured. I mean, in addition you get a dollar's pay. Okay, officers even go to master's degree in reputed defense colleges abroad. Then Navy sends every year handful of officers to Royal War College London, US Marine Staff College, etc. And same is the case with Army and Air Force. The kind of facilities and luxury these officers receive in those countries are unmatched. Okay, next. Scope for higher education. If you are a studious person, then this is the place for you to be. Because it is unfortunately that people think if you are not doing well in studies, then I should be joining Army. Or people will say, "Achha, yaar, isko army bhej dete." It's not so. If you want to have a future in army, you should be studious. Okay. Any successful officer, by the time he retires, ends up doing one or two master's degree, that is MSc degree, oblique MPhil, oblique MBA in your life, like he and me both have done that. But paid study leave for 2 years to pursue higher education, then no other organization gives so much paid leave to pursue higher studies. Okay. Then technical officers have the opportunity to pursue M.Tech from IITs in course of their career. Seats are reserved for armed forces. Okay. Then before retirement, if you wish, you can attend executive management course from IMA, MDI and other top management institute, where the fees is as it is low for the armed forces people. Out of that also 50% is paid by the armed forces and 50% only you have to pay. And 6 months you are on paid leave. Okay. So that kind of scope for higher education is there. Yeah, next. Respect wherever you go. The respect you will command from your soldiers, subordinates, the society and even your family is something you will never be able to get in any profession. 100% of the time you will, even if you don't wish to, end up being a role model to your children. I interviewed 2000, he also must have interviewed maybe more. But then you ask, who is your role model? Always his army officer, son will always say, my father. Okay. So what Field Marshal Manekshaw said, you won't be rich, you won't have wealth, but you will have something much better, respect in a professional army. You will be respected wherever you go. Okay. Yeah. Next. Yeah. This kind of smartness you can only achieve as a... Can you see anybody like this outside? Okay, next. Health and family life. Regular physical exercise, whether you like it or not, you have to do it. Okay. Regular medical checkups, then healthy lifestyle, then families are well looked after. So they are always kept busy or they always have an opportunity to do well. Then good family life. Yes, because family is looking at you, how hard he is working. My father is working or my husband is working, so they definitely respect you. It is not that ki ghar ke aane ke baad ki ye khatam ho gaya, wo khatam ho gaya, to ye chalna hai, aap ghar ki taraf dhyan hi nahi dete ho. Nothing like that. Okay, you will be doing only your job. When I say this thing for girls, it is spouse. Okay, if your husband will not nag you ki ye kaise khatam ho gaya, wo khud jaake leke aayega. Samajh gaya? Okay. Then family is also respected. And family is proud of you. Okay. And finally, separation builds up stronger bond. So remember that some people are of the opinion, you know, field area mein jana padta hai, family se dur jana padta hai. It is good for the family life. Okay, that family realizes the importance of his absence, okay, or her absence. So therefore, that also helps. Okay. Yeah, next. Great post-retirement options. On retirement, apart from the handsome amount that you will receive, you will get a pension throughout your life, that is ORP, whether you retire or take a premature retirement like both of us. Today, an officer with 30 years of service after retirement gets pension approximately 1 lakh per month. Okay. Even after retirement, with their qualification, experience and knowledge, the officers of the armed forces are most sought after for a leadership roles in big companies. The armed forces nurture each officer into a leader, which is second nature. Hence, a second innings post-retirement is very probable and equally attractive. Okay? So, zindagi ke baad bhi was this concept. Okay? Continue. Yeah. Next. Challenging and thrilling life. Okay? No other job. I'm sorry repeating time and again, but I served in army, then public sector, private sector. Nothing like armed forces job. Okay? The opportunity to work in different roles and organization and places. You are a scientist sometimes, you are an assessor sometimes, like SSB, I was earlier served in DRDO, I also served in J&K, I served in Rajasthan. So you keep changing your job. It is not that one role and one place you serve. Okay. Then non-interference of politicians and civilians. Absolutely no interference. Nobody can influence them. Then decision making. You have to take a decision, whether you are a lieutenant or whether you are a general. Decision is a part of your life and you will take decision and nobody will question your decision. Okay. Then leading and leading well is professionally most satisfying. Okay. Becoming leader is something different and remaining a follower is something different. So would you like to be leader or would you like to be follower?
Leader.
Okay. Yeah. Now, if such an attractive picture I have given to you, then you must know also, okay, how do I join? Okay, so therefore, that all this, if you see this, on top is the NDA insignia, then thereafter, this is IMA, then Air Force Academy, Naval Academy, and Officers Training Academy. Okay, yeah, how to join Armed Forces as an officer? First, you will have to clear your entrance exam like NDA, CDS, APCAT. Thereafter, Services Selection Board, sir will cover in detail and apprise you how that interview is. Then there is a medical examination, which is again a thorough medical examination. But a normal person need not be scared of that, because most of us are physically means internally fit. Physical fitness we'll see in SSB itself, but not like that somebody will tell you to run 5 kilometers, nobody is going to do that. It is just 3 minute obstacles that you'll have to do, and if you are fit, you are fit. Okay. Then training at Training Academy. There you have to be mentally tough. Training will be very tough, but then it is all here. If you are not physically fit, they will make you fit. But if you are not mentally fit, then possibly you will not be able to take on. Okay. Yeah. So first we'll talk about NDA, just for your convenience. Okay, yeah. UPSC conducts examination twice a year. Notification issued in June and February. Online application by end of June and January. Examination conducted in September and April. Result announced in December and June. Next exam is September 2017. The course will start in next July. Okay, vacancy, NDA about 350 vacancies. Okay, every 6 months there are 350 vacancies. Out of that, 200 are for Army, 50 for Navy, 100 for Air Force, and in addition there are around 55 vacancies are for Naval Academy. But however, these vacancies keep varying with each course. So some minor variations are there. You can always see that in the notification. Yeah, next. Quickly, citizenship, all of you are citizens of India, so no question. Something about Nepal and Tibet refugees, you are not concerned. Anybody Nepal, Tibet? Anybody from Nepal, Tibet? No. So we will not cover that. Age limit, NDA 16.5 to 19 years. The age range of NDA 2, that is 2017, starting the exam in September, that you should be 2nd July 99. Between 2nd July 99 and 2nd January 2002. Okay. Education qualification for Indian Army Wing, The candidates appearing for the examination must have passed or appearing class 12th from recognized board or university. The only difference is that there is no requirement of physics and maths necessary. For Air Force and Navy, it is required. But look, even though I said this, but if you do not have a science background, possibly you will become end up being an infantry soldier. If you want to be gunner like both of us, that is the technical as well as physical both combined, then you have to have some technical background. Okay, yeah. Examination pattern. NDA exam consists of two papers, maths and general abilities. Mathematics paper is a 300 marks and consists of multiple choice question based on syllabus of class 11th and 12th. The time allowed to write the paper is 2.5 hours. General ability test comprises of two sections, section A and section B. The section A is English, 200 marks, means one third of the second paper is of English. Then section B, 400 marks of general knowledge. General knowledge covers almost everything. Okay, yeah, next. Mathematics syllabus and other thing, you can go through that in notification in detail here. I'm not going to cover that. And next, how to prepare. Just keep certain thing in mind. Syllabus is quite elaborate and requires a good preparation. If you are giving this, I'm first preparing for AIEEE. My choice is JEE. And third choice, I'm giving it to NDA. Possibly, you are going wrong. For the obvious reason, the syllabus is very vast. Unless you pay attention to this, very difficult. Okay, so therefore that you will have to pay a lot of attention to the syllabus. Yes, if you start now only, suppose you are in 12th or 11th? 12th. So your math, physics you already done. So it is only question of other subjects. So you have to concentrate. You have to be systematic. You should start preparing immediately after relevant test or as soon as possible. Then guidance from a qualified and experienced teacher by joining good coaching institute. Why I am recommending this, not that because I am standing here. The basic reason is that you require a systematic preparation for this. Okay, and that systematic can, somebody has to guide you for that. And that's why this is a necessity. Okay, start by making notes on each topic. Personal notes are very useful during the revision time. Okay. Then you can purchase any dedicated book for this exam. Make sure you are up to date in current affairs also. Okay, so therefore that whatever book you purchase, you decide, you take somebody's guidance and do it. But then start preparing now. It is not that I will last 2 months I am going to study or last 1 month I am going to study. May not help you. Okay, yeah, next. Next is CDS exam. Yeah. Why opt for CDS exam? Yeah. Interesting for most of you, girls and boys both. Okay, less competition in screening as compared to any other competitive exam for equivalent post. Okay, so when I'm making this statement, I'm making with a lot of responsibility. It is apart from APCAT, this is one of the easiest exam because it is just a screening. Let's be very clear. One should not be thinking CDS exam as a big hurdle. CDS exam is reasonably good exam. Not much tough. Okay. Then next is give the opportunity to all three services of the armed forces. You can opt for any of them. Then least possibility of merit out. Especially if you are opting for army, there are a lot of vacancies and unfortunately the right kind of boys and girls are not coming. So therefore if you make it in SSB, you are likely to come in merit also. Okay, girls, especially technical graduates, they have problems. If they are looking for a technical graduation as a career, non-technical, some competition is there, but not so much. Okay. Next is more vacancies as compared to other graduate entries. Okay. So therefore, this is the you should opt for CDS exam. Okay. Yeah. Next. General information. UPSC conducts examination twice a year. All of you know it. Then notification issued in October and June. Okay. Online application by end October or June, and examination conducted in February and November. Okay. But again, here also, you have to start preparing now. Don't look that, now it is in November, so I have a lot of time. No, you'll have to prepare, start preparing now. Result is announced in April and January. Next exam, 2017 for CDS, course starting in June 18, that will be in November. Okay, vacancies, approximately 450 vacancies. Okay, every 6 months. That is IMA, 150 vacancies. Naval Academy, 40 to 50. Air Force Academy, 30. OTA men 225 including NCC cadets, OTA women non-technical. These are the 15 to 20, but it may be more also. It depends on the course to course. Okay, yeah. Eligibility criteria. Citizenship, again I am not going to describe that. Age limit 20 to 24 years. And for OTA, short service, it will be 20 to 25 years. I want to clarify here that short service also should not be playing on your mind. If you are not a mathematics physics student and you want to appear for a OTA, because there is no mathematics there. So therefore that you should do that. If you are doing well, if you are a sincere and honest officer, you will get permanent commission. We do not reject officer unless he proves otherwise. If you want to prove that I am not fit to be an army officer, then yes, we will not continue with you. But if you are fit as a gentleman, you will be